Hi, welcome to the session on CMA Part 1, Financial Planning, Performance, and Analytics. This session will discuss about the cost accumulation systems. Different companies use different costing methods based on the nature of the business operations. So the accumulation systems which we use here include a job order costing system, process costing system, activity-based costing system, and life cycle costing system, JPAL, job order costing, where you charge the customer based on the job. So you don't have any predefined rates for your products, rates for your services. Process costing system is used in the companies where you have a massive production process which passes through different stages to get the final product. Activity-based costing system, where you have expenses, some costs which are to be shared by two or more products because you are incurring the cost in a combined operation, but this operation is used for two or more products to be produced. So the cost allocation is done based on the activity involved. Life cycle costing, in which we extract the total cost incurred on a particular product from its inception to its exit from the market. But this is not the end. We will have discussion on each and every costing method in a separate topic with some numerics. So let us begin with the job order costing system. What is job order costing system? Why use a job order costing system? Which type of companies use job order costing system? And how do we find the cost of a particular job? Job order costing system. A job order costing system is used when a particular job is going to be performed based on the specifications of a customer. So the specifications of customer is different from the previous customer and the next customer. Say, for example, construction of a building, interiors, auditing, designing, travel, legal advising. So these are all distinctly different from customer to customer. We cannot say that last time I charged, say, $150,000 to this customer for the construction of two-story building, I will charge you the same amount. Come on, no way, because the design is different, the pattern is different, the material is different. So I have my own specifications. You cannot charge the same amount to me. Okay, I have these specifications. You tell me what is the amount you are going to charge for these specifications. So the costing is purely based on the specifications given by the customer. And each specification, we call it as a job. Okay, so for each and every job, a job sheet is opened and we see that what is the material that is spent on this, what is the labor cost we incurred on this, and what are the other expenses, we call them as manufacturing overheads incurred on this particular job. Then we add our margin. We add our margin or profit. That is going to be the cost of the job. Right. And this job is going to be different from the previous customer. Okay. Because we collected the requirements of the customer. Based on that, we are providing this information. So obviously, the amount which we charge to a customer is different from the customer which we are going to accept in future. For each and every job, you will have a job number, a ticket number, and you will inject the cost which you incurred on that particular job. So the customer will be charged based on that. Okay, so please remember three costs: material, labor, and overhead. Because we are waiting for the customer's instructions, unless otherwise we get instructions or specifications from the customer, we will not be able to provide any cost. Therefore, it is called as customer-driven costing method. Customer-driven costing method means what? Costing is purely based on the customer's instructions, customer specifications, customer's requirements. And this kind of products called heterogeneous products. For heterogeneous products, we use job order costing. Heterogeneous means the product, the service is entirely different from customer to customer. You cannot say that this customer is order is same like the previous customer. Customer to customer, you have different requirements. Okay, so you will have specifications from the customer. Based on that, you will be charging. Those products are called heterogeneous, like interior designing. Okay, designing, auditing, legal advising, construction. Yeah, so this type of companies use job order costing when we provide any kind of services which are distinctly different from the other customers. You see, this type of companies which I underline here, they do not have unique rates for, you know, the fixed rates for each and every customer. Okay, so it is purely based on what? The services, the nature of the services, the quantity of the services which we provided to the customer. So in a job order costing, first of all, we need to identify the job. So there will be an identification of the job. Say, for example, job number 1, 2, 3. We identified. Then trace out the costs. Direct costs like material, labor. How much material I incurred on this particular job and how much labor I incurred. That's the reason I call it as what? Direct material, direct labor. I know that what amount of material that is used, like quantity times rate. Hours, that labor hours times the labor rate. In addition to this, I must charge some indirect expenses called overheads also. Like what? My factory rent, electricity, repairs, maintenance, depreciation. These are all called indirect costs, also known as what? Overheads. So the overheads are charged based on some allocation. Okay. We predetermine them and charge according to that. Right? Say, for example, for a particular job, I used a material, like say 20 kgs of material at the rate of $5. So what is the cost of the material that is used for this particular job? $100. I use direct labor, I maintain a log sheet, I provided 100 direct labor hours, 30 direct labor hours at the rate of, say, for example, $1 per labor hour. So what is the labor cost? $30. Now, in addition to this, I have the indirect expenses called overheads. Say for example, in a manufacturing plant, I spend $30,000 per month. This is the amount I spent on an average in my factory for 1 month. In a month, I can extract 10,000 machine hours. So I just calculate the total overheads per machine hour, which is called predetermined allocation or predetermined overhead rate. In my company, I consider machine hours as the base and I calculate what is the rate per machine hour, say $3. Then I'll check how many machine hours are used here for manufacturing overheads. To charge, I check how many machine hours are used. Say for example, 15 machine hours are used to complete this product called job number 1, 2, 3. 15 machine hours times what is the predetermined overhead rate here? $3. So $45 is the overhead rate. So which consists of what? The depreciation of the machinery, factory expenses, repairs, insurance, property taxes, entire indirect expenses. So the cost which I incurred on this particular product is $175. Say I add my margin of $100. So the job cost is going to be $275. This is what I'm going to charge to the client. Direct material, direct labor, we can trace out immediately. But in case of overheads, we need to have a predetermined allocation rate. We consider the total expenses what we incur in a month for a given manufacturing machine hours. Then when we sum up all these, we get total cost. Then we can add your profit to get your price. Yes, we know that all the indirect costs of producing this particular job or performing this particular job, we charge based on a predetermined overhead rate. Predetermined overhead rate, say for example, we estimated the total overheads of a workshop, a production facility, say $50,000 per month. This is the estimated overhead per month. In that month, we are expecting that we can extract 10,000 machine hours. So we use machine hour rate, predetermined machine hour rate as $5 per machine hour. So we see that how many machine hours are used to perform this particular task to complete the job. That is multiplied by $5. So this is called denominator level. Denominator level. So denominator level can be machine hours if we use machinery to operate or to execute this work. Can be labor hours, direct labor hours, because our company is highly labor intensive industry. So the overheads are incurred based on the number of labor hours we worked. So the denominator activity level can be machine hours. If you use maximum, the process using the machinery, labor hours, if the industry is a labor intensive industry, or we may take labor cost, direct labor cost. Means what? Dollar amount as the basis. I'll explain you with an example, direct labor hour as a basis. So in the first example, I used here machine hours. If my company doesn't use heavy equipment, but we use lots of labor hours to complete the task, so I may use say, for example, here 5,000 laborers in a month. So I'm using a denominator as direct laborers as the basis. In that case, it will become what? $10. Suppose I use direct labor cost as the basis. How, say, direct material is $10,000 incurred to complete a particular job. Direct labor is, say, for example, $4,000. And manufacturing overhead, I do not use denominator level, you know, concept here, but I just use as a percentage of the direct labor cost, a dollar amount. Say, for example, with the historical information, my manufacturing overhead is approximately 40% of direct labor cost. Got it. Say, for example, if I spent $100,000 of direct labor cost, I spent $40,000 approximately on manufacturing expenses like depreciation, insurance, rent of the factory building, repairs, maintenance. This is the historical information I got from the previous months, plus or minus, of course, but around 40,000 we are getting. So I can estimate that it is around 40% of direct labor cost. So here I'm going to calculate 40% of the direct labor cost as 1,600 here. So the cost of this particular job is 15,600. So we have two direct costs here, direct material and direct labor, and manufacturing overhead is estimated. It is estimated, assumed, absorbed based on a labor cost, based on the machine hours, based on the labor hours. So in case of machine hours and labor hours, we calculated predetermined application rate. In case this example, we used as a direct labor cost as a basis. So depending upon the industry, depending upon the treatment, we should apply this. In all the cases, you have three cost components, which include what? Direct material, direct labor, and the manufacturing overheads. Here, manufacturing overhead is absorbed, is assumed, is estimated based on what? Based on machine hours, based on direct laborers, can be based on direct labor cost. Yeah. So depending upon the industry's policy, you need to apply this. Okay. So we are just assuming the amount of manufacturing overheads based on the past experience. It can be under applied, over applied, and their treatment in the cost of goods sold and income statement. We'll discuss this in the coming topics, but at the moment, just understand that manufacturing overhead is applied based on either machine hours, labor hours, or direct labor cost. Here we said that job order costing is suitable for heterogeneous products. Heterogeneous products are the products in which the customers give us some specifications, the requirements. Okay, the requirements. So we need to have a questionnaire that what is your requirement. Based on that, I can give you the cost. Whereas homogeneous product is a product which is common to everyone. I produce this product cost is $25. Customer 1, customer 2, customer 10, customer 100, whoever it is a homogeneous product. It is common for everyone. It is not specially made for you. It is $25, anyone. That is called homogeneous product. I produce and sell. I don't wait for the customer specifications. But in case of heterogeneous products, yes, I cannot produce unless you give me the instructions, what you need, what you don't need. Okay. Right. So the process in practical in the industries will go like this. First of all, when you accept any job, you allocate some job identification number. Okay. So you will have some kind of extra information that when you initiated this particular job, when you completed this job, what is the quantity of this job, who is handling this job, what is the job name, etc. Clear. Then this particular job should give you, you are a management accountant looking after the cost accumulation, cost control, you know, cost reduction. Therefore, you need to know the clear cut information on this particular job, how much material you incurred. So you pulled out this material from the warehouse with some requisition number so that you can get the details of the material which you pulled out from the warehouse. What is the amount? You hired the laborers and you got this from HR. So there is a ticket number that how many laborers are, you know, engaged on this particular job, how many hours they spent on this, and what is the labor cost. Then you absorb the manufacturing overhead, either machines, based on machines or direct laborers, then the rate, calculate the amount. So you have direct material cost, direct labor cost, and manufacturing overhead. The three costs are in your hand: material cost, labor cost, and manufacturing overhead. You can find the total cost here. You can even find the unit cost also here. Based on this, you will be charging the amount to your customer. Now we understand the job sheet and arriving at the total cost of the job so that we can add up some markup, which we saw our profit, and charge it to the client. Let's take an example here. I have a job number 1, 2, 3, which will require a material of 10,000. I extracted some information. The direct labor cost is required $5,000, and manufacturing overheads, which is based on the labor cost, assuming that it is 40% of labor cost. Say for example, it is going to be 2,000. 40% of 5,000 is 2,000. It can be, you know, direct laborers or machine hours. Yeah. The total cost of the job is 17,000. Say I want to have a profit of say $3,000, then the selling price of this particular product is going to be $20,000. This is the selling price. So the markup, you need to decide well in advance that how much is a markup. Like sometimes it is a percentage or a dollar amount. Okay, how much you are going to add up. It depends upon the present market demand for this particular product and service. Yeah. Let's take one more example here. What is the, you know, total cost of the job, which, you know, required 25 special machines to be produced. We allotted the job number as 100, which required a direct material cost of 45,000, manufacturing labor cost of 14,000, and this company uses the machine hours as the denominator level to allocate the manufacturing overheads to the jobs. This particular job used 500 machine hours. Okay. And we have some information here that the manufacturing overheads incurred were 65,100 for a total of 2,480 machine hours for all the jobs, not this job alone. So We have direct costs readily available here, direct material and direct labor. But indirect cost is to be arrived at. Okay, now let us find out the cost of job number 100. 100. So we allocated the job number 100. We picked up the direct costs from here, direct material 45,000, direct labor 14,000. Now we need to calculate the manufacturing over it. So this company is using what? Machine hours as the base, right? Jake Jesco chooses machine hours as the only allocation basis, right? So we have got some information here. $65,100 of overheads are incurred for 2,480 machine hours. So we need to find out the predetermined machine hour overhead rate, that is 65,100 divided by 2,480 machine hours will give you what? Say $26.25 per machine hour. So if you consume one machine hour, it will cost us $26.25. And this particular job consumed 500 machine hours. So I multiply with 500 machine hours to arrive at 13,125. So the total cost of this job is 72,125. This way you need to arrive at. Please read the question properly, that what is the treatment that is used for the transfer of, for the, you know, charging of the manufacturing over it, whether it is charged based on the machine hours or labor cost. You need to read carefully and apply the manufacturing over it accordingly. Perfect. So we have a material cost of 12,500, which is from the job sheet, then a labor cost of 1,620. Then calculated the manufacturing overhead from the information given that in a month we spent $180,000 to get 30,000 machine hours, and this particular job consumed 150 machine hours. Therefore, the total manufacturing overhead cost absorbed for this particular job is 900, arriving at the total cost of the job of 15,020. This way, we find out the cost of each job. The advantages of using a job order costing system in a company is, first thing is we will have a detailed analysis about what is the cost of the material we use for this particular job, so that we can know that what is the standard material cost that is allowed, what is the actual which we incurred. Is there any variance? We can check this. We have a separate topic of performance analysis. In that, we will be using the material cost, which is allowed to be spent, material cost, which is actually spent. We'll have a detailed analysis there called variance analysis. Likewise, how many labor hours are required to be used here? Standard. We find well in advance. And we see that what is the actual number of labor hours incurred, what is the labor cost we incurred, what is the overhead we incurred. All this we'll discuss in a variance analysis topic about material, about labor, and about overheads in the coming topics. Next, we can estimate the cost of the job that will help us to, you know, price a particular product, a particular service. Okay, so that we can see the profit from that particular job. Yeah, and also we can estimate well in advance in providing the quotations, etc. Then we can find out the predetermined overhead rate so that it can be allocated to the other jobs. We can even find out, is there any spoilage which is normal or abnormal? We should take an action to control this so that we can minimize by taking corrective steps, and also we can, you know, evaluate the efficiency of the jobs. We can see the performance of the people engaged on a particular jobs. That way it will help us to, you know, have an efficient costing method in the companies. The disadvantages, we need to spend good amount of time to get all this information. In an additional, you know, time required to find out the labor cost, wages cost, you need to maintain a log sheet for the laborers who are engaged in a particular job, then extraction of the overheads. Sometimes the overhead allocation is wrong. Okay, your company is using heavy labor hours than machine hours. So which denominator level you are considering here? If it is a labor intensive industry, you are considering machine hours, applying machine hour overhead rate to a particular job, it may give you wrong information. If your manufacturing facility is using lots of machines, the overheads are in a direct relation with the number of machine hours you use, and you are using labor hours as the basis here, it will give you wrong results. So you need to have the appropriate denominator level to collect the overhead rate. Okay, right. And the estimation of overhead rates, overhead amounts may be wrong sometimes. If you estimate the overhead rates based on the estimated overheads are wrong, you will have a wrong calculation. This is a disadvantage on the job order costing system. So just to have a recap on job order costing system, we call it as customer driven costing system because unless otherwise the customer gives us specifications of a particular job, we will not be able to provide the cost of the job. It is suitable for only heterogeneous products. Means what? The product is distinctly different from customer to customer. Okay, so one customer's specifications are different from the other customer's specifications. They are called heterogeneous products. And the direct costs are assigned to the job numbers. What are the direct costs we discussed here? Direct material, direct labor. We can maintain some, you know, sheet, a cost sheet, giving the information in the cost sheet that what amount of material that is used and what is the amount of direct labor. In case of manufacturing overhead, the third indirect cost that is absorbed based on a denominator level can be machine hours or direct labor hours based on the nature of the industry which uses machine hours or direct labor hours mostly. Or you can have one more note here. Some companies may use direct labor cost as a basis instead of hours and all. So as a percentage of direct labor, how much you incurred here, we take some percentage, like say for example 40% of labor cost. It can be based on machine hours, labor hours, or based on the direct labor cost. And you should make a point here that under job order costing system, we do not have any beginning and ending inventory. Why? Because purely we get an order from the customer. We get an order from the customer. Based on that, we start injecting the material. It is purely based on the instruction from the customer. So there is no question of beginning goods before we get an order from this customer. There is no question of having ending finished goods which will be supplied to the other customer. No. So you do not have any beginning and ending finished goods in a job order costing. You have raw material which you will use in this job. Okay, but no finished goods, no work in progress in a no work in progress, no finished goods beginning or ending in a job order costing. Why? Because it is purely produced based on the customer specifications. Why should we produce more than the customer's requirement? Why should we produce, you know, more? And why should we use the beginning finished goods? Where are they from? We should produce only as per the customer's requirements. Okay, this is about a job order costing, and we'll discuss about next costing method called process costing method in the coming sessions. Till then, have a good time. See you in the next lesson.